So finally, if the transaction commits by calling an end transaction, at that point, all the changes that have been made to persistent data structures have to be written to the log segment that records the redo logs for this application. So at this point, LRVM creates a redo log in memory of the changes that have been made to the persistent data structures. That is, this region that has been modified, it's going to be written as a redo log. So it doesn't know within that region, LRVM does not know within this region specified by base address and the length, where exactly these data structures are contained. All it knows is that this is the portion of the address space that is being modified in the critical section. That's why it's so important as a developer to make sure that the data structures that you're manipulating are within this region that you have signaled to LRVM. LRVM is basically thinking that there is a contiguous set of addresses starting here for a certain length that may have been modified in this critical section. So the log record that it writes is basically saying, here is the start address, and here is the number of bytes, and this is the new data that goes into this virtual address space. That's what LRVM is creating as a redo log in memory. And remember that redo log is itself a data structure of LRVM in memory. We should not confuse the redo log with the external data segments. External data segments are the persistent versions of the in-memory data structures. Now, this redo log is the changes that have been made to the in-memory versions of the persistent data structures that have not yet been committed to the disk in terms of the external data segments. It's now available at this point, at the end of end transaction. It's available as a redo log entry in the log segment, which was initialized by this application. Now, the semantics of this transaction is, if it commits, then all these changes are now available on persistent storage. So what the LRVM library has to do is not only create the redo log record, which is a data structure in memory so far as LRVM is concerned, but it also has to flush these redo logs to the disk at the point of commit. And only after that, we can assume that all the changes that have been made in this critical section has been persisted on the disk. So it has to flush to the disk synchronously, meaning that this end transaction waits for this redo log to be flushed to the disk. At this point, it is on the disk. However, again, in order to make sure that we can have a performant implementation of LRVM, there is a mode available in the end transaction, and this mode says no flush, meaning at the point of end transaction, you don't necessarily have to block the caller for the flush to be complete. Transactional semantics would require that the process that is executing this commit should not be allowed to go past this point until the synchronous I/O has completed from the redo log into the disk. But in order to make it a more performance conscious design, if you think that power failures are rare and the chances that your server is going to crash is not very high, then you can go ahead and say as a developer that at the point of end transaction, I want you to commit it. By the way, you don't have to block me. Or in other words, this mode, if it says no flush, it is saying that, yes, I want you to commit it to the disk, but don't block me from going further. So the changes that have been made as a redo log record will be committed to the disk later depending on the specification of no flush. So as a developer, if I say no flush, then the redo log is not going to be synchronously written to the disk. So I can go ahead. I might do another transaction that might write more log records. So I can reduce the number of I/O operations in committing these log records to the disk. So that's an opportunity that I'm exploiting by giving this no flush mode in the end transaction. So it's an opportunity for the application to both reduce the number of I/O operations and also make sure that the application is not blocked here, waiting for the synchronous write to the disk to complete. So once the transaction is committed, meaning that LRVM has created the redo log for this particular transaction, then the undo record is no longer needed because undo record, if you recall, was created just for the eventuality that this transaction may not commit. But now that the transaction is committed, we can throw away this undo record. On the other hand, instead of the end transaction, the transaction may actually abort. If it aborts, then what LRVM has to do is restore this portion of the virtual address space of this process from the undo record so that we have gone back to the state before this transaction ever happened. So in other words, we're making whatever code that the server executed as a critical section code between begin transaction and abort transaction to go away. And we restore the computation to its state before the begin transaction by copying the undo record into the portion of the virtual address space that has been modified through this critical section code. So that, in a nutshell, is how you would use the primitives provided by LRVM in constructing a server that has certain persistence requirements.